starting salaries for officers just going forward in 2016 would be $40,053, and then 17 would be, well, after one year service, they'd go to $28,900. And then now they're going to the same person, and then year three, it'll be $66,000. So even though, you know, the grant is going backwards, and we're going forwards, we're going to get our money.
You can hope that my age is not good.
Did you say somebody has to get a tax system or a student here?
That might be there, but I think that's all over. I'm saying is, he's hoping to hire a teacher, who's just for the test, the test of civil service, all the peace officers we hired, who took the test, sourcing test at the county. After they pass that test, their grades and their qualifications go to civil service. Who doesn't hire?
Pardon?
Yeah, that's how service.
I think that was his plan.
Yeah, but I think his luck.
He kept saying we can get an extra police officer if we take this grant.
Right.
That was his exact word. So to get an extra police officer, you have to hire him.
Yeah,
like
you didn't know if we gave it up for him first.
Well,
do you need confirmation that you put in for the grant?
Yeah, well, we knew we put in for it, but we proved it at the last meeting. That we did. This council approved it. Matter of fact, he said he had 5 days to get it in.
I would think if he was a part of this MOU, I would think that he's familiar with it and did put it in. And maybe he gets fingers. The only thing I'm going to suggest, if everyone has a problem, this one line that says the district agrees to fund 50% of the SRO's salary up to $12,500 for the first 3 years. I would like to say for each of the first 3 years, because it makes it sound as if the $12,500 is just for 3 years. It's for 3 years.
It just says
12,500 for the first 3 years. I just need to be specific and say that's each year. you have a guarantee too that you have to come up with one that you're wearing?
I apologize, I didn't hear.
About a guarantee, the, was it the State Department?
That was granted in this open space grant.
Open space grant, or was it the grant?
Whatever the grant is, that we're buying, we're using the price of the property, we have to guarantee 74, the borough has to guarantee 74,000. Just a base one.
Which grant are you talking about?
The open space grant that we're using to buy the property.
I have not heard that, okay, sir.
Okay, so that's the county.
We're using the open space grant to buy that property, right?
That's the county's.
That's the county, I don't know why they would do it.
No, we're not doing that.
It may be the requirement of the grant. No, but I don't know if that's about.
Exactly.
Well, you have to guarantee it.
I'll guarantee, I'll write it down.
Well, if we guarantee it, we have to have that one, right? That's a guarantee.
Her response was, by the way, Allison's response was, no, nothing you can do on the agenda, nothing you can do on the agenda. So apparently there's nothing you can do on the agenda. What happened, this, all right, you have to.
No.
I wanted to bring up again the hack room that I sent out to everybody. Sorry, I didn't mention it. I hope you all brought it. I've talked to a few people about, and I'm sitting in the middle, the pushback I got was, that others in Bucks County haven't adopted it yet, but I was talking to Allison, and she said it's, it's slowly making its way to Bucks County. I think that a lot of townships, boroughs have adopted it in Montgomery County. So, it obviously is, it's not something that people have seen, but the thing that, was appealing to me were a few different things. If the homeowner or the owner of the property is residential, commercial, or industrial, they don't have homes being matched with them, I mean, this is going to be a lot of money, so we probably won't do it, but we would actually have the county to have an extra, I guess, because then the property was probably going to be a huge deal. Something that I think we need to, you know, be thought of, we're not going to do this, so that we don't have residential or commercial buildings, buildings in the middle of our town, that's just sitting there and nothing's happening. So, not necessarily, I mean, you have things, you have to condemn, you have to think of many different things.
Utilities.
Condemned, but, this, I think, is sort of a middle ground between, not between its hedges and its house probably the street. So this would just be if they owe any sort of, as you were saying, if they have any sort of back taxes, they would sort of, I think it's for water or garbage, I think, and sort of permits.
Are taxes included? I know utilities definitely, but can we?
Final, fund, maintenance costs? And, yeah, then something comes up.
And you wind up with a judgment, then you gotta find.
We have a part of this, is, if it passes, we have that part, or hasn't been, all the time, I don't know, but we don't, and we push it out, right?
The property maintenance, that's been on for, yeah. I think something.
I think it's, I think that it's just something that is sort of like a vicious cycle, that people just, you know, they take it for, they pay the fine, and all this, and, especially if they don't live in the area, I mean, I asked, certain properties, and this kind of person, that owns the property, doesn't live in Marshall, they don't live too far away from here, but they're really just letting the properties, so, I mean, I.
We need to throw our arm up, because we're looking for.
Yeah, I think it's a good way to, if they want to.
Is it rental, is it rental property or not?
This.
We talked about another property, where it's.
This particular property, not, like, there's no way in this, this particular property, but, again, there's somebody.
He's on.
No, he's.
Because we have a property on Main Street, and the gentleman died, and the wife is in jail, there's a, we'll cut the grass.
Yeah, but this is, this is.
We'll cut the grass, and we'll get it back when it gets sold.
The benefit of this is, if you call it a mall, or you think you work for somebody outside, you work outside the state, you're all over the world, it's a big, like, form of difficulty, to get every kind of satisfied, something like that, you should be, of course.
And if somebody owns a lot of properties, if they decide, oh, this one's not, what has happened to this one, which one is one, but this one gets a lot of, you know, renters, and, oh, I wanna build a deck, and it's kind of like, can't.
Well, yeah, this is the document, I think.
Yes.
Is that one thing, so if you're, if you own multiple properties, you get, you don't get permits for any of them, it's like all of the stuff?
Yes.
Well, I like that.
And that does, of course, that's not to give it, right?
Right.
Okay.
Right, exactly.
You're on the list, the gentleman can be right now.
I think someone else in the area has adopted this, so far, it's been set up.
How old is he?
It's from 2007, 2011.
The cities have used it a lot, cities with, you know, 150,000 people, multiple, like, cities that have no, probably have control on it. Like, in Morris County, the house is, it's really in Morris County, because they have hundreds of properties.
Yeah, but they're owned by people outside the city, outside the state.
And it's all relative, I mean, you don't have the cousin, just from all time, managing.
The only choice is to put it to you, and I don't think you can, you can use it or not.
Right, exactly, it's not, there, the whole stuff, you can, from the beginning, which is like some, you know, this isn't what it's about, like, you can play, it won't, crash many of those, so.
I think this is a property, rental property, ordinance.
You don't need it for that.
Well, that's what I was thinking about talking with Allison.
They have one, there's yours, you told me.
And we had a lot of people that own rental properties that don't live in Marshall, 47%.
45%, well, somebody would own it.
Right.
So.
We're only 60% of the lot, if that, maybe less than that.
So I think this is just a small step in the right direction, we can.
Can't hurt. You don't have to use it, you know, for that.
Is there any way to, no, I guess it's just probably people, those businesses, you know, just sort of stuff, certain, segments of it that would work better for us, you know, really.
I'm thinking maybe do it that way, or you just.
Not the way, of course, you're saying.
Well, at the same time, again, I like, if you're adopting ordinance, I really wanna be able to actually enforce, you know, having all the laws, just saying this is true.
And I was like, you're trying to. Yes. I talked to her, I think she, I think, actually, I think I gave to you guys, and she quickly aside, I think she's been talking a little bit, but, last week. And she, I mean, she wants, she was all for it, actually, I actually emailed her, or I even told her about this, 2 months ago, and said, I'd like to talk about, like, what it is, and she's the one that said to me,
Well, she already, it's already on her radar, so why don't we just ask her to review it?
It's an opinion.
It's an opinion, or let's say, hey, that, it's good, just put it in the manner.
All right, when it comes to talking about the lawsuit, SAC, the fact of taxes, dollars, like the title of the lawyer, things around the, seeing how the money, or the other, and they came in, somebody else bought it. I got taxes up on it, right? And there it sits. That's how it is now. So this was missing, and it's been 2 years now. We've got hands and the parks from the stairs and some of the.
They just took out it. I don't know that.
What? Oh, yeah.
That's
well,
a good one.
It would be used for something, right? I mean, it was not. But it was not. That
it was there.
It was there. Prior to the first mess.
So there's a perfect one in all of our downtown that has had the money. And you have a property that's so.
Well, I think the problem with that one was, from what I understand, it was a business they were kept getting cleaned out of bankruptcy. So we really stopped from being able to do it. It's a starts to file with banks. You can't win.
Well, that's a problem.
So I don't know what the pull up is now. But as far as it was January, we got that, I think that it was supposed to be in the world. Now, I don't know what we can do as councils to push in any direction, but I would definitely accept it. Because it has been, I think everybody in town.
Since 19, when's the company sound? You had a problem?
In the early 90s.
In the early 90s? This is not.
Yeah, this is a new guy.
Yes, but it's but it wasn't.
Well, they had a lot of structural problems because they couldn't go to the
My understanding is completely concrete inside and out, so structure is fine, but it's not a hotel. It doesn't have an elevator.
Well, the elevator wasn't.
Yeah,
so some of these are big bills, they're not 100, 60 months, they're years old. They just don't pay.
If you have the old people, they'll say, I'll pay you when someone's, no one's ever.
Even then, you know, that's my, but,
And the utility, like, if you go for a commercial property, normally you don't, always necessarily take the trash, so you can't go back in that utility. You don't have control of that, I mean, I guess if you like it, but you know, maybe it's water, that's not our bill either, and you don't have our electric. So what utilities do we want to do that?
Sanitation. Water and sewer. Okay.
But I think we could be able to use in conjunction with some of our ordinances, that if they're fined because their property is a blight, then that could be used as something to put back.
Well, it's also clear that our maintenance plan would come from the board says, see that something is going to be.
Oh, I certainly, I definitely don't want new things to be unprotected.
Like the house of peace though.
Yes. Because that house of peace is not good.
She was fine, and then the judge, the lady's died now. So now it's, and then her sister was taken care of, plus two, and then her sister died. So then we have two houses here. It's an old town, we have a lot of, unfortunately, passed away. So now it's going to sit and sit there, and have to keep it around, and it's not to sit until they. Well, then they, when you talk about the debt, but we really own them, right, next to.
Well, that would fire, someone would fire.
Okay, right. I think you ran out of money.
So if I have particular places in mind, what would tax be charged as a.
If the owner or the developer had another piece of property, he would be not.
And that's.
That would be the developer. Pay a few bills in this room, give you.
And that's what's in the market, that's the way to go. Is in the property, so you might need to do something, just to finish the room, so
sure.
Well, so what do you decide, will it,
Well, here's what I do, and there's some.
And give some suggestions about the, you know, the safe living.
Because things can be placed against property for violations. Municipalities can take property owners to court to subject them against owners to assets. They may deny permits to own buildings under code violations, deny permits to own buildings under taxes, and impose any permits to commit other municipal crimes.
Even code violations?
Yes.
I mean, to me it's a long way, but I mean, what could you lose by having a problem?
And I would definitely use the means, I don't have a lot of guest gaps in. I would like to ask you to, A, make sure that it's good for all purposes. And like I said, I talked to her briefly, and she could see the things for me to go. B, make sure you contribute the other walls on our walls.
Well, we all agree. I think that's all good. Just ask for our opinion.
Okay.
Right? Is that good?
Yeah.
Is that your position? So, that's good. I said something last week about medical cannabis. It's something that was, it's a hot topic. But I don't know what to do, which is kind of going on. And
they didn't vote on it right now.
Were those two
Yeah, that's what it says on television, I only look at the ads.
Fibromyalgia, is it supposed to remedy that? Fibromyalgia.
That's in the bill?
I would like to bring up something that there's that.
I have no problem with you on the photo resolution. I have no problem. I have a letter resolution too. No specific issue. Yeah, it's, the sign is not that clear, I think. That may be good.
I think the Bucks and Bills Association will send you that resolution.
And they intend to support it?
To support it, yes.
Yeah. Right?
I think it's not a definition of it.
Right.
Two other things for the board. One, we're going to advertise for the board meeting. Should we?
You should.
I think we have to do that. We've taken the contract, we've got somebody else.
We have election, that's in a year, it's not, we have to hire a board member.
Well, if you hire one now, you say they're not going to be back.
I think you have to get one on board by now, you don't have anything to get one on board.
She said advertise, I mean, it could take, I mean, for a vetting process, like what we want is possible. It could be a couple months, well.
The chief took one, 4 or 5 months.
And there was three, there were three candidates when I first got there. I think it's July, I mean, who's the one?
Well, I think somebody should stop looking at what you want to advertise. What your start date would be, how much money you think you can pay with this person?
Probably be line item, things on budget, if you want a part-time or part-time manager.
Start this budget, I think you can. Do you want a gap again? Gaps don't work.
You want to hire interim ones too, that's what you do, like, where are you hired?
Right.
What happens if you're lucky, signing, maybe not the whole person, because the process of paying to advertise and bring the person in.
You might not even get those candidates until January. So maybe not. I mean, it's already.
You might not want, you might not want it.
Right.
But you would not receive it.
No, I meant, for management.
It is sticky, I really come with you.
I think that we all have nominations and.
You can't control what happens after that.
You told me.
So you're talking about putting out and advertising and going through the process of looking for a manager, and this person's going to have the idea that they're going to be hired when Tom leaves in December, but you don't know what the council place is going to be after the election.
Sure, if you're just for a manager, they know that.
They tell you that.
And we have to do the budgets. I assume we're all in the board for the department, you or she, to be a full-time employee, so we're going to have to print some of that money, we're going to have to put that in there.
And he's going to have to see the comments. What did you say?
So when Adam's in the comments, starting.
Starting the process doesn't mean you have to end it. You don't really have to select any bodies.
Are we all agree that that's going to should be a full-time person, right?
Yes. Yeah, okay. What are you supposed to find that, this qualification that we.
The manager for himself would have somebody at the university that was sold for hiring managers. I'm contacting my network.
You might have what you need.
Also, it would be an outside entity that would be doing that.
That would be next to the article, this one.
I
sign it behind the name. It's all.
You look in your Winnebago magazine, the Borough magazine.
Yeah, just take it.
They'll tell you.
Take the information from the back page.
Yeah, and look at when they're such and such a borough is looking for a Borough magazine, and you'll see the exact kind of thing.
Well, we could even advertise in that, so the cost of that is about $700.
By the time that happens. But there are different kinds of things that goes on the internet. You don't decide.
Well, in my conversation with John Bro, who's a former manager of the library, there's actually a consortium of borough managers that he's going to send some
It's amazing. It's funny.
You can show up on your
for the park itself.
I don't think that's as vital as deciding whether
it would be done by your product while this is happening. I'm just gonna say something. Since that fence was taken down and over where the secret line field, there used to be a smaller area that was gravel. It's now huge. Now more gravel, I said something to Bob, because I feel like we have a big huge pile of stone sitting there, and then I'm like, where is it coming? Now the stone's spread out and it's brought into the past where our fence used to be, down on that end of the road.
So the park is
So, to me, unless there's some boundaries put there, we just get more parking for baseball and fields. We only have that one area that's right there that still hasn't straightened out as far as the T-ball field. There's been work on that. And then we go to the meetings or the parking lot. Because that's going to be part of our budget coming up too, if we deal with that. So, but what's happening is, you've got the NBAC's working on the plan that others have really all sat down and said, okay, we can look at this and decide.
Well, they haven't completed it. I just talked to them last week. They just haven't completed that decision. We don't have a session on it.
Well, they didn't finish it.
They didn't read it to us, and we're not even done with it yet.
Do you want them to?
She asked me if they wanted to, if they should continue on the plan, and I said, yes, absolutely. But they are, I will tell you, their focus is the southern end. I think my personal opinion is we need to focus on what we already have, which is happening. And I think we need to.
If you're going to have, out of the open space fund, you're going to have, what, that $85,000-$90,000 left of that money that still has to be used up by the end of 2016. So that's going to be the
That would be nice, but I don't think we can guarantee that. There's not much.
Well, out of that, you have what, you have two. 94 for the last 297, you took a 202.65 out of that. You're going to have a difference there. For the purchase of the school. Well, that could be a difference on that. But I'm saying,
still,
out of the open space, still, it's going to have budget.
Final amount.
Right.
You got out of 294, 245 is attractive.
No, because they're not going to ask anyone to do it.
But the grant is for 225, which includes our matching, not their contribution. Are we sure that they're not considering the 245 grant subtracted from what we will avail?
I'm saying
the grant is for 245 out of our 294. So I believe we only have the balance remaining from 245 and not 202.
Well, either way, there's not 80,000 in there because we had engineering fees and we also had attorney's fees. So we're probably down to.
I'd be open space fund. Make your actual plan that part of the first thing you should go for is I'm saying though, if you don't have an actual plan that it's all decided on, this is what is going to be. You can feel changes, but you need to come up with exactly.
When MEAC finishes their plan, then we'll go to us, and we'll take a look at it and see if there's something.
They have data.
Well, I feel a path.
They have a great path
one.
Through the southern end, but I think they're trying to move the whole
thing. Right, well, that's why I thought we were going to bring something.
It needs to go from the northern end to the southern end.
Why are they looking at the southern end?
Is it underutilized? It's just sitting up there?
Well, the concern
be a great
is,
down?
The concern is they
want
to make sure money goes up. They're going to use that.
It's not that easy.
When you cross that bridge, I mean, it's entering into your town.
The part that's the park?
She's talking about the part that is ours. I'm telling you, it comes out. They're absolutely, the MEAC wants absolutely, their goal is to make sure that nothing is built.
Oh,
just like you have
the it's not nothing, it's still on the baseball.
No, I think one of the
building.
You remember the
gateway?
Oh,
yeah,
no buildings. That is the goal.
Is there enough room there?
You have people to walk
no,
on the day from the capital to eat in downtown. It would be a nice area to have a nice plant to just and stuff to sit there.
You don't want to go inside.
No, no, I'm just saying I don't think the people
that's
who walk stop. Came from the dried up creek when they built the dike.
That is our
mill.
Somebody had
it.
Let me go back to the
original
question. Back to
Tony Gold. They had open air.